Oh, thank goodness for this. Thank goodness for this. Now, I know what you're thinking. Mike, you're saying. But surely this is Streets of Rage. You don't get to play this yet. You've got to work your way to S before you can even hope to play this, along with Shinobi and Shadow Dancer and loads of the other good games that you just can't play yet. Fair point. But the bottom line is this. This, on a technicality, is bare knuckle. And the main thing is, I need this. I've just played two Barbie games back to back. And it was an utterly traumatic experience. I can still feel its cold, clammy grip on my soul. I need some Streets of Rage. So I don't care what you think. I'm going to play 10 minutes of bare knuckle. Let's do this. Alright, I'm going to pick a character I never pick usually. Adam. I never use Adam for some reason. He's too big and chunky, I think. Let's try him. You might notice something else as well. I've also taken all the filter effects off the emulator because I think it starts to get a bit blurry when it gets to YouTube. I love this game. So yeah, it just seems to make sense there. Let's get it down to its pure pixels and see how it comes across. I did that a few games ago, actually, and I forgot to mention it. Oh, I love this game. It's sort of all those grab moves. I know we're not really seeing them yet because I'm just tearing my way through all the baddies, but there we go. Love all that. Love it. It was just, that was such a unique thing. Final Fight kind of did it if you use Hagger, but only kind of. It was sort of fleeting the way. Look at the reflections on top of that car's face. I don't remember that. There's like touches in the Japanese versions which aren't the European versions. Maybe that one is, but I don't know. You just never know which is and which isn't, and sometimes you notice things that, you know, we're there anyway. Have that. I love this game. I usually use Axel or Blaze for some reason, and the same applies to Streets of Rage 2. But that's what I thought. As I'm getting to play bare knuckle, I'll do something a little different to use Axel. Oh, the broken bottle. Oh, come on, give me a chance to use my bottle. Yes. It's just such a good game. It's just a charmer as beat-em-ups go. As brawlers go, that's a sub-genre really, isn't it? Although brawlers have changed again, haven't they? With the likes of Super Smash Brothers and that. I know from the kids in our school, I didn't really know anything about Super Smash Brothers until I started working at that school. Now Retro Arcade every Thursday and Friday just becomes the Super Smash Brothers, well, brawl. Because they love it over everything else. A lot of them do. Oh, I'm getting a bit overwhelmed here. I think because Adam's a bit slow, isn't he? I'm a bit out of practice. It's got some repos. I'm not really going for a perfect goal or anything. I'm just blasting my way through it. Taking a few hits while I'm at it. Having a bit of fun. Generally playing badly. Yeah. Have some of that. And you can... Oh, I was hoping to throw him into his mate, but flipping pipe was in the way. Pipe. Baseball bat. It does look really rudimentary when you break it down to its pixels as well, now that the pixels are so clear. Bearing in mind that back in the day, these games were shown through the filter of a CRT telly, and looked nice and blurred. It really actually improved the look of the game, to not be able to see the pixels. But I'm quite glad to get rid of that weapon. Maybe I could spin move, I can't remember. Wait, he goes, yeah. This is a bit rubbish though. Oh, that's right, he does that thing where he punches them a bit, then punches them up in the air, like that, and then sends them flying. And I can't get to do it now. There we go. Oh, I could have done with that before. That's it, he kicks him. Oh, didn't want to do that, wants to save that for the boss or the sub boss. Who that probably, no, well, it isn't. Love doing that. So Adam, I guess, is more about the standard move, that, because that's quite powerful. He's not so much about that, because he's quite slow. Yeah, it is a boss. Could really have done with that big piece of beef or whatever it is sat there, couldn't we? Oh well. Oh yeah, the dude at the boomerang. Boomerang Joe. Did I just punch that out there? He's got a spare in his pocket, he's alright. He'll manage. See, it's so slow getting to him. which is why I never used Adam. I think, look how slow he is. Slow. And when a baddie's running circles around you like this guy is literally doing, it's so frustrating having a slow character in a one player game. If there's two here, it's well easier, obviously, but is that it? Yeah, here we go. Yeah, that's ace. And this is one of those trilogies where the sequel to this, at least, really improved on it. But the third game should be an improvement as well. I mean, graphically, it's an improvement on the second, kind of. The characters, it's not really. The characters go off on one a bit. And they're not as likeable. They're not as kind of human. There's that weird cyborg guy, isn't there? And he's not as you know, identifiable with Ubble. He's harder to identify with. What's his name? Zan or something? I can't remember that. But sneak up behind me. Cowards like him. That's what he wanted. Oh no. Hey, that works. I forgot about that. If you hold jumping up when they throw you, you land on your feet. No, I'm done. Nope. Yeah, and the characters just weren't as human as the ones in this. On Streets of Rage 2. Which you'll see, because I'm going to play Bare Knuckle 2 next, is a vast graphic improvement on this one. Bigger sprites, better animations, a few better gameplay details as well. Sort of special moves on the A button. Oh, there's the A button. I just hit the A button to demonstrate that there's no special moves. I totally forgot about that. Call the cops. Should have saved that for the boss, like, but you only get one of them a level, pretty much, I think. Pretty cool. In Streets of Rage 2, of course, you get special attack moves, which take up your energy a bit, I think, if I remember correctly. There is some trade-off to using them. I think that was what it was. After that, Mr. Punkman with the purple hair. Funny little characters, aren't they? And Streets of Rage 3, while it was much more vibrant again, as I say, it didn't have the same sort of charming characters, well, player characters, but something that really I didn't like about it, and it's, again, it might be just a personal thing, but I think the music really took it downward, a turn for the worst. The music in this is great, it's dead memorable, you can remember all the tunes, all this diddle and all that. These tunes are all kind of embedded in the heads of a whole generation, you know. And the same with Streets of Rage 2. Those Streets of Rage tunes are really in there. And Streets of Rage 3, it's like they've got the same kind of techno sensibilities, but it's like they've forgotten melody, you know. They've forgotten how to do melody. And it might be that, I think it might even be the same person who did the music. Which seems weird to me, because it's like that person forgot how to write a song, and you kind of get these weird techno beats and stuff, but you got this like total lack of melody. I mean, it sounds like it's deliberate, but it was one of the things that made Streets of Rage great, these tunes. Oh god, I hate the slow walking stuff. Don't worry, when we play it at Streets of Rage later on, I'll be using Axel Oblige and blasting through these levels. Like, that is frustrating. And then to walk into his flames at the end of all that. Maybe I can just jump kick him out of his hand. Because you can hit him out of his hand and he regenerates him too, like that. That's better. I need that. He's doing those big thunder punches. Working my way through them, punching my way through axes and flames. You don't see that very often. Oh, that's cool. After that, you don't see that very often in Streets of Rage either, I'm grabbing you. Luckily, I was able to do something about it. Now, that is the Japanese version of Streets of Rage, and probably from what we've seen, it's probably not much different to the European US Streets of Rage. Maybe it is. I haven't seen any noticeable differences yet. But that's that. Bare Knuckle on the Sega Mega Drive. I'm going to have a look at the sequels as well. And we'll do Streets of Rage later. Okay, thanks for watching. I'm going to kill him. Yes. Ooh, and, I love this game. Uh-oh. Boss. Oh, he's nasty. Right. Thanks for watching. See you later.